There is no better driver in the world.
Why don't they make it safer?
Risk of death turns people on.
Who's that?
It's Niki Lauda.
He's just been signed by Ferrari.
I'm both quicker than you and better at setting up the car.
Obviously, you weren't driving 170 miles an hour, but I'd imagine there were still some moments where you thought, this is what it was like.
We did a lot more than we thought, you know? Yeah. I think insurance is always at the beginning, don't do this. And then the nature of the shoot became a little bit sort of improvised and kind of quick jump in the car and we'll get this shot. That was hugely exciting and just adds to the thrill of it all, but also your, understanding of what these guys were doing.
This is an incredible battle between these two drivers.
I'm really glad that that I had all the previous filmmaking experiences behind me when I had the opportunity to make this. Trying to recreate something, as we sort of did with Apollo 13, that was technically accurate and authentic, but those characters were very simple and straightforward. I love character pieces like Frost Nixon or Beautiful Mind, but you know, the logistics aren't challenging in those movies. Here's one where both were involved, and it definitely the degree of difficulty level was as high as anything I think I've been involved in.
You're just the party guy.
I just wonder what it was like being on set with him and being directed by him.
I absolutely loved it, and I think all of us loved it. And although he's done all these incredible films and he achieved so much in his career and he's a superstar, really, at the same time he's such a modest person and a wonderful man.
How much more pressure for the actor is there in portraying real people, and in your case, Daniel, someone who's still alive?
If you're lucky and the person likes you and is willing to get in touch with you and deliver you information that you can never read anywhere or see anywhere, it's a big luxury.
So Niki approved?
Niki approved. It wasn't clear from the beginning, you know. The first conversation we had on the phone was, I guess we have to meet now. And I said, yeah. Just bring hand luggage to Vienna. In case we don't like each other, you can piss off right away.
Niki Lauda, trapped in a searing inferno of 800 plus degrees.
Most people don't have a very realistic understanding of who they are or how other people see them. But Niki has a very sober and clear-eyed view of life and of himself. And so he was a joy to collaborate with, and I think he's proud and moved by the film.
You get a hint about what Niki thought of your portrayal of James Hunt in the end?
I haven't met Niki yet, but I've heard it's he's happy and pleased. There were incredibly contrasting, contradicting views on James and who he was and what he was about, and and then there was this sort of the larger image we know of him as the playboy and rock star, but there was a whole other side to him, and so it became about, okay, what's my most honest interpretation of this?